So here we have the Hyundai Tucson on a 16 plate. Going to start off by showing you around the outside of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But from the outside, you can see it's a 5-door car with alloy wheels. Let's start off inside the boot and then work our way around the rest of the car from there. So as we approach the boot, you can see we have reversing sensors. This car's also got a reversing camera, plenty of boot space as well, along with that 60-40 split folding rear seat. And then underneath this tray section, not only is it a full size spare wheel, but it's got an alloy wheel on it as well. Okay, so we're just going to work our way back round to the front of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But now that we've done a full circle of it, you can see it's in excellent condition the whole way round. Just briefly before we climb in, I think it's well worth seeing the interior from this exterior point of view. There's plenty to run through on the dashboard, so let's hop in and we'll do that now. Okay, now that we're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. On the left-hand side, we have the rev counter, and on the right-hand side, the speedometer and fuel gauge. In the middle, you can see the total miles for this car, which are 5,224. The information displayed above that can be changed using buttons on the steering wheel, so you can have a digital readout for the speedometer, as well as various different bits of fuel economy information. There are also other menus available, so satellite navigation, lane departure, your audio menu, vehicle settings and user settings, and then we're back round to the beginning again there. To go through those different settings, you just need to use these buttons here. This car's also got cruise control and speed limiter over on that side of the steering wheel. And then on the left-hand side, we have stereo controls and phone controls at the bottom here. They can only be used after such time as you've paired the phone up, which is done over on the touchscreen just here. Hit the phone button and then follow the instructions up here. We're going to cancel that for now though. When it comes to music in this car, firstly we have the radio. We've got FM, AM and DAB available to us. If you hit the media button, nothing is connected at the moment, but that would otherwise bring up your various different options in terms of listening to your own music. You can connect up an auxiliary device, a USB device, so you can also stream your music wirelessly via Bluetooth audio as well. So once you pair your phone, not only can you make and receive phone calls, but you can listen to your own music as well. If I put the car into reverse, we have a full colour reversing camera just there. This car's also got satellite navigation. There's a full video showing that working on both our website and our Facebook page. Working our way down, we have the dual zone climate control. So you can adjust the passenger temperature and the driver temperature, the fan speed up and down. You can determine where within the car you'd like the air to be distributed. This button turns the air conditioning off or back on again. And at the bottom here, we have heated driver and passenger seats, both with three different heat settings each. Under that, we have two 12-volt charging sockets, as well as the auxiliary and USB inputs. We have a 6-speed manual gearbox. And then these buttons just here. Starting from this one, you can turn off the parking sensors. This car's got stop and start, which means it's designed to cut out when it's stationary in traffic to save you fuel. This button turns that system off. We then have these two buttons here, which I will show you up on the screen. So the first one turns on downhill brake control, and that green symbol has come onto the right-hand side of the speedometer. And the one above that will turn the steering mode from sport to normal. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.